Okay, good morning class. So today we'll start with the phylum Aesculapinthes, and it is advancement over the phylum Platyhelminthes. So these are including the roundworms. This phylum also called as the phylum Nematoda. They are triploblasting, having three layers, the endoderm, ectoderm and the mesoderm. Then they are pseudocoelomate, that is having a false coelom. What is a false coelom? The coelom which is not developed from the mesoderm. So the shape is cylindrical, rounded and vermiform. So the vermiform is a term that is only used for the Aesculapinthes when we are talking about the structure. So it is a little advancement over the Platyhelminthes. Now where are they found? They are found in the mostly in the aquatic condition, and they can be found both in the freshwater and marine condition. Sometimes also found in the soils. And what is the major place that they are found? They are majorly found as endoparasites. The endoparasites are those organisms which are feeding upon some other living organisms, and they are completely dependent on them. So I told you the word oblique parasite or obligate parasite. So the term obligate parasite suits best for them, that if they do not get the nutrition from other organisms, they won't be able to survive. Endoparasite. Endo means living inside. So they are endoparasitic and found both in animal and plants. So the body is not segmented, and the body is also elongated, means the length of the body is little larger or taller as compared to the Platyhelminthes. They have tapering ends. In the diagram you can see the tapering ends. These are called as the tapering ends, the hook shaped ends. So the anterior end, the end which is present at the early most position, they show some degree of syphilization. So syphilization was the process of formation of head. So the syphilization is present at the anterior most end. So this can be said as to be the anterior most end, and this part shows some form of syphilization, and syphilization is recognized only when we see that one part is having some nerves in it and it is working as the नर्वस सिस्टम ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो जब भी नर्वस सिस्टम हम लोग को मिलता है, उस जगह को हम लोग हेड बोलते हैं, एंड दैट्स वॉट वी कॉल एज सिफिलाइजेशन. देन कम्स ट्रिप्लोब्लास्टिक. आई टोल्ड यू द बॉडी इज हैविंग थ्री डिफरेंट जर्म लेयर्स, बायलेटरली सिमेट्रिकल. सो इट इज एडवांसमेंट दैट इट इज हैविंग सिमेट्री दैट इज bilaterally symmetrical, and when the division is cut is made from anywhere, any position, the body is divided into two equal halves, but only in one plane. If we divide the body in this plane or this plane, we cannot get equal halves. So the bilateral symmetry, the cut made and the two equal halves are found. Then comes the body wall. The body wall of this is thick and tough. So this outer covering is very much thick, and it is dubbed for protecting itself from the outside environment. And it is also been lined by a cuticle. A thin cuticle layer is present. This layer is also for the protection purpose, so that the heat or extreme cold conditions can be overcome by the help of this cuticle. It is a little waxy. Then a syncytial hypodermis, a layer below the epidermis, the layer present just below the uppermost layer is called hypodermis, and this hypodermis is syncytial. Syncytial means one cell having many nucleus, and it is made up of muscular, means they contain muscle fibers, and these muscle fibers are arranged into four longitudinal quadrants. Longitudinal quadrants means, maybe it is shown in the diagram somewhere, no it's not there. So means they are having, quadrant means four, so four muscle fibers are arranged in one position, that we call as the four longitudinal quadrants. So this layer, the layer below the epidermis or the uppermost layer, is called as hypodermis. It is syncytial and having some four longitudinal quadrants in it. So now we'll talk about the digestive tract of this. So digestive tract, it is mainly this intestine, and I told you the alimentary canal in this is completely formed. So the digestive tract in the case of phylum Aesculapinthes, it is a straight tube and it is having a terminal mouth. So this is the mouth, as it is having tube within tube body plan, mouth is present, anus is present. Mouth for ingestion, anus for egestion. So now the circulatory and respiratory system. These both systems are absent, though the respiration occurs by this general body surface. So this general body surface have some pores for the respiration process, and then the circulatory as well as the respiratory systems are completely absent. Now talk about the excretory system. So excretory system is a little complex in this, and it is a major distinct feature that separates this as Helminthes from others. So this system is consisting of canals or gland-like organs, and the flame cells which were present in the case of Platyhelminthes are absent in this. Nervous system, the nervous system in this includes a ring. This is the when we cut a section, a round section is cut, this kind of structure is formed. So let's continue with this diagram only. So the nervous system includes a nerve ring. All this nervous system is present in the anterior part, because the anterior part includes all this part below the mouth, and this all includes the cephalization process, that is formation of head. So the nerve ring is present in the anterior most part. This is the this is called as the posterior part, and this is called as the anterior part. The upper part is called dorsal, lower part ventral. So these are the four parts which are present in according to which the body is divided. Each body, whether it's of human beings, any animal. So these are the four most criteria which divide a body. So anterior most part contains nerve ring, and nerve ring are including in the nervous system. So reproductive system, now we talk about it. It is also very well developed, and also there is a particular distinguishment between the female and male. So male and female are being distinguished easily only by the outer surface. If we look at Ascaris for example is also an Aeschylhelminthes. It comes under the category under the phylum Aeschylhelminthes. So if we look at an Ascaris, we can tell very easily that this is female and this is male because of this hook shaped or tapering end present in the male. It is also shorter in size. So there is present sexual dimorphism. So this is a word which is used when two different genders of the same organism are easily distinguishable only by the when we see it from the outer structure. That for example human beings also we can tell this is a male human and this is a female human. So this is how this is what we call as sexual dimorphism. In this case also sexual dimorphism present, male smaller than the females. Now what about the fertilization? The fertilization in this is internal, and development is usually direct. So there are no different stages present. The development occurs directly, and fertilization is occurring internally only, not in the outer condition or not in the water. So the life cycle of this is complex, and there are usually four larval stages present. So the life cycle of this undergoes four larval stages before forming a complete adult Ascaris or adult Aeschylhelminthes. So what are the examples of this? Ascaris is the best example if we talk about the Aeschylhelminthes. Then under the others can be Vocheraria, then Enterobius, Heterodera, all this comes under the phylum Aeschylhelminthes. So now we'll talk about the Annelida, the phylum Annelida. It includes all the bilaterally symmetrical organisms. Bilaterally symmetrical, again, the organism which on division are divided into two equal halves. They are also triploblastic, but here one advancement is there that they are true coelomate. That true coelom is present, and the true coelom is the one which is developed from the mesoderm. The segmentation starts from here. So they are metamerically segmented animals with their body covered with a thin flexible cuticle. So in this also the outermost covering is cuticle, and the metamers are present. Metamers is the one unit of segmentation. This is one metamer, this is another metamer, this is another metamer. So all these segmentation are formed by the combination of different metamers. Now this is the first phylum from where the segmentation started. or we call it as a true segmentation started. So about 9,000 species of these phylum are present. Phylogenetically, the annelids are the first animals to acquire a true coelom. So till the Aeschylhelminthes, we have seen that only no coelom was present, or either coelom was present, it was a false coelom. So that's why in this we can see that the first, these are the first organism if we talk about phylogenetically, that these have the true coelom in them. So they are cosmopolitan. The word cosmopolitan is used when some organism is found everywhere. So these are cosmopolitan in distribution. They are found in the aquatic conditions as well as on the terrestrial environment. They shows organ level system of organization. So now again it's an advancement. Till here we have seen no organ level system of organization, only tissue level was present, but now the organ system level of body organization have started. They have paired appendages. Paired appendages, these are the paired appendages. The appendages which form the structure for moving, they are attached together. So they are paired. That is occurring two in one metamer. The one metamer containing these appendages present this side as well as this side. This we call as the condition paired appendages, and these paired appendages are called as parapodia, and they are helping in the movement of the annelids. And now the body wall. So the body wall of this, or the body wall musculature, consists of circular and longitudinal muscles. So muscles is present and they are advanced. They are now they are having a shape that is circular as well as longitudinal. So both the shapes have started to be present in this phylum. They are covered externally by a moist cuticle. So outermost moist cuticle, the second layer, which was in the case of phylum Aeschylhelminthes, it was the hypodermis. And hypodermis was consisting of some muscles. There were quadrant of muscles, or four muscular fibers arranged in one cell, but here the muscles are both circular as well as longitudinal. Now the locomotion. So the locomotion or the movement is by chitinous seta, and sometimes they can be present or sometimes they are absent. Not in all cases they cannot be found, only rarely found. So these may be of locomotory. These may have the locomotory ability, and sometimes it is not present. So the digestive system is complete. Now in this, the digestive system has completed. Till the Aeschylhelminthes, there was only the development of alimentary canal, but now the digestive system is completed, and it extends all along the body of the organism that is present, starting from the mouth and ending to the anus. Then the blood vascular system, or the circulatory system, is of closed type and consists of longitudinal blood vessels of the coelom sinuses. You see this muscles, the circular muscles present and the longitudinal muscles present. The seta, which are helping in the movement, they cling to the sides, and then they grab that place. They make sure that their grabbing is so much potent that they can now move further with the same function or the same process. So they cling to a place, then they attach themselves very perfectly to this place and then move ahead. So these seta are the major organs of movement in the case of annelids. These are the two types of muscles, the circular and the longitudinal muscles. And these muscles help in the contraction of the organism. Now this, the circulatory system. What does the circulatory system consist of? It is closed type. Closed type means it is present inside the body. You can see this is the outer covering of the body, and these blood vessels are found inside the body. Then comes the respiratory system. So respiratory system now started to have some pigments. What are the pigments? Hemoglobin or erythrocrocurin. So it is erythrocrocurin is a pigment that is respiratory pigment, and it is only present in the annelid. So this is a distinct feature of the annelids. It is dissolved in the blood plasma. As in the case of human beings, hemoglobin is present. Same, this is also a respiratory pigment. Same in the annelids also, the pigment, that is respiratory pigment, is dissolved in the blood plasma. So now respiration is, it is also by the general body surface, like that in the case of Esquilhelminthes. So what are the organs of excretion now? This is the complete diagram. If we see, talk about the section cutting, this internal as well as external part, both are being shown very nicely. So now we talk about the excretion, organs of excretion. They are metamerically repeated nephridia, which are ectodermal in origin. So the ectodermal in origin means they are being formed from the ectoderm. So these are the nephridium, and they are present at many positions, not just in maybe they are found in these metamers, and then after some non-availability of this nephridium, again they are found in these metamers. Matlab ki nephridium present ho sakte in do metamers mein, aur phir kuch time tak ye absent honge aur phir ye present honge. So they are repeatedly present all along the body of the annelids. The organ of excretion is called as nephridium. Now we talk about the nervous system. It consists of a pair of cerebral ganglia. So from here the nervous system started to be composed of a complex structure that we call as ganglia, the cerebral ganglia, and a pair of circumesophageal connectives and double ventral nerve cord with segmental ganglia. So these are the segmental ganglion, these are the cerebral ganglion, two types of ganglion present along with the circumesophageal connectives. These connectives are used for joining the two kind of ganglions. Sensory organs, now sensory organs are present, also present in the annelid. They were absent in all other phylums which we have studied till now. So the taste buds are present, photoreceptor cells are present, eyes are there, and statocysts body present. So what are the taste buds for? For tasting. If they are eating anything, they are absorbing anything, then they can taste that thing. Photoreceptor cells are for the purpose of watching something. Then they are having statocyst bodies also. They are uni or bisexual. They can be both uni or bisexual. Uni means they are having two male and female different genders present in the same organism. But bisexual also, that same organism having both male and female part in it. Then the cleavage is spiral and determinate, that is the development direct or through a trochophore larval stage. So in the case of annelid development, there is a formation of trochophore larva. So this trochophore larva is only present in the annelids, and again this is a distinct feature. So some organisms, some annelids can also be producing through asexual methods. And what is the asexual method they use? The budding process. Then they have high power of regeneration. Regeneration means if they lost this part, once or two metamers are being lost during if they are fighting some enemy or they are being caught somewhere, then these parts have the ability to form again. So this is the process of regeneration. The example of these So now we have talked about this, or the power of regeneration, and how they have the ability to regenerate again and again if they have lost some part. So this was all about the phylum Annelida. Moving further, we have another phylum, the phylum Arthropoda. So it is a phylum which have a very high amount of organisms or species present inside it. So the phylum Arthropoda, it includes the all those organisms that are having bilateral symmetry, that is again cutting them from one plane, and then the body is divided into two equal halves. They having a protostomial eucoelomate eumetazones, and they have metamerically segmented body. So now what this term means, I'll discuss it. First, let's start all the characteristics. Body triploblastic, having three germ layers. Coelomate, true coelom was found in the annelids, and it will continue further on. So the coelom is true in this case also, bilateral symmetry, and they are also metamerically segmented like those in the annelids. They possess a chitinous exoskeleton. So this is a feature that was not found in the annelids or any other phylum. Chitinous means this outer exoskeleton, the outermost part of the arthropod is chitinous, that is made up of pigment called chitin. So that's why it is called as the chitinous exoskeleton, and it is very providing the durability to the arthropods, and it is very hard. These organisms which are having a chitinous exoskeleton, they undergoes a periodic molting, ichthyosis. The molting is also called as ichthyosis. What does molting means? They have the ability to shed this exoskeleton at one point of time, and then this complete exoskeleton start to form again. So this is what we call as molting or ichthyosis. The each segment of this, the three segments are the head. This includes the head, the from here to here the thorax, then from here to here the abdomen. These are the three segments. So now what does these three segments bear? All these three segments have a pair of jointed appendages, and these appendages are used for locomotion or feeding or sensory purposes. So this this segment, the head segment, is used for the purpose, that is mainly for feeding and sensory purpose, that is having, it is having the sense organs for they are having photoreceptors for seeing things, then it is having taste buds and smelling power also. Then these two, thorax and abdomen, have the locomotory structure which help them to move from one place to another. So then there are a few segments, the anterior segments. These anterior segments, there are some segments which have the ability to undergo cephalization, and they form a distinct head. Now the coelom is much reduced, and sometimes it is also replaced by perivisceral hemocoel. So what is the perivisceral hemocoel? It is distinct only in the case of arthropoda, that they have the coelom very much less or very much small in amount, and sometimes it is also absent, and in that place there comes a hemocoel. A hemocoel means a cavity that is filled with the blood. So the hemocoel replaces the coelom in case of arthropods. So digestive tract is complete, and the mouth parts with are having the lateral jaws. These lateral jaws are adapted for chewing and for sucking. So their mouth is made for chewing and sucking purposes. Till now there was no such mouth present till the annelids. Now we can see the mouth has also start to evolve, and the chewing and sucking function have start to form. Circulatory system is open. In the case of annelids it was closed, but now it is open. The blood sinuses are being distributed throughout the tissues. The body musculature consists of separate stripped muscular fibers, and they are capable of rapid action. The circulatory system, first you see this is the hemolymph, the lymph, fluid that is present in the heart, and it is being delivered to all the body of the cockroach. So cockroach is a very peculiar example if we talk about the phylum Arthropoda. This is open kind, and a closed type is this. So this is the difference between an open type of circulatory system which is present in Arthropoda, and this is the closed type which is present in the annelids. So this is the tubular heart. There was only auxiliary hearts present in the, and it was being completely inside of the body, but now you can see that it is present on the outermost portion of the body. So this is the tubular heart, and this is auxiliary. There are small branches, vessels in each organ, and these are mainly for supplying blood to the various body organs. But here you can see they are nerves which are being imparted particular function to transfer blood to a particular position. So this is the difference, that these are the vessels that are common for all the organs, but these are distinct vessels which are peculiar for transferring blood to particular organs. So this is an advancement. The arthropoda have a well developed circulatory system as compared to the earthworms. Now talking about the body musculature, that is the outermost structure of the body. It includes striped muscle fibers, and they are also capable of rapid action. So the muscle fibers are present, and these are very flexible. That's why they help the arthropoda to move from one place to another very easily and give a very rapid response to whatever the stimuli they are receiving. The body is devoid of cilia. There are no cilia present in the body of the arthropoda. True nephridia is absent in this case. There is no presence of true nephridia. So nephridia was an organ of excretion. Now how the excretion takes place? Excretion is carried out by the coelom ducts or by the Malpighian tubules. So the Malpighian tubules is a peculiar excretory organ in case of arthropoda. Central nervous system is of again consisting of some preoral ganglia, and these are also connected to the ventral nerve cord, and commissures are present. These commissures help in the attachment of the various nervous system to one another. Then the ventral nerve cord is present. It is double, single and segmental ganglia, and these all are comprising into one nerve. So now the nerve system has started to evolve from just having ganglia. Now the nerves are also being seen, and they include all the different kinds of ganglia inside them. Now the sexes are separate in this, and they show evident sexual dimorphism, means they have complete different organism for male and female. Male can be distinct very easily from that of the female. So this in the diagram you can see the ventral part of the arthropoda. These are the various appendages that are helping in movement. Now male and female are completely distinguishable from one another, and the best and the very distinct criteria for dividing arthropoda is that they have very special kind of eye that we also call as the compound eye. So what does this compound eye consist of? It is an organ of sensory receptors, and it is mainly for the photoreceptor organ. So the compound eye, one unit of compound eye is consist of ocelli, and ocelli are the minute pores present in the eye which help the cockroach or the arthropoda to see our image, which is divided into various segments. So as we can see the image very clearly, the arthropodas are not capable of seeing that image clearly, and they are having an image which is segmented into various small, very minute parts. So these ocelli are being joined together to form a compound eye and give the arthropoda a visual image that is made up of very minute distinct segments. Then they are oviparous or viviparous. Oviparous means sometimes they may lay eggs, and sometimes they may give rise to a complete individual. The development can be direct or indirect, and the larval stages are present. So larval stages in the butterflies also comes under the category arthropoda, and these are the different larval stages. The process of developing a complete adult from an egg is called as metamorphosis. So the first the egg is being developed into a larva, then into a pupa, and then to the adult. These are the various larval stages. So the king crab, that is the limulus, Pelamius the scorpion, Bombyx the silkworm, and the musca housefly, crab, Apis honeybee, Culex mosquito, all this comes under the kingdom the phylum arthropoda, and these are the organism that we see very easily in our day-to-day surrounding. Now comes the phylum Mollusca. These are the soft-bodied organisms. This phylum constitutes the organisms that are either free-living or sedentary. Free-living means they can be present in one position and have the ability to move to the other position, and sedentary means they are being aligned to one particular place and they cannot move from one place to another. So though mostly they are marine, only some cases they are freshwater or terrestrial. If they are terrestrial, they are present in damp soil. Damp soil is a soil which is having high content of water, so mostly they are having marine conditions. The body is again bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelom is present, and it is unsegmented. Only one species present, that is Moloplacophora, which is segmented. Other all the species of mollusca are unsegmented and they do not have any appendages. Body is divided into head, the ventral muscular foot, and the diagram you can see the body is divided into head, then comes the other, the head, then comes the other part, the ventral muscular foot, that is present in the lower condition, ventral mass, mantle, foot. These are the three body divisions that you can see in the diagrams. Then the skin is soft, and over the hump it forms a mantle which secretes a calcareous shell. This is the calcareous shell, the mantle. It is hard and this is very soft. So because of the very much softness of the skin of the molluscus, they have this mantle which is hard structure, and this is usually for helping these soft bodied organisms for protecting themselves from the environment. Talking about the digestive tract, the that is very much complete. The mouth is commonly with a rasping organ. This rasping organ is called radula, and it is having some teeth also. So now from here the teeth have started to develop. These are the radula and the teeth you can see. Then our digestive gland is also present. Circulatory system is open, and it is arterial and venous system. So in human beings you have heard of arteries and veins to be present. So in this there is an advancement over the all other phylum, that they have a circulatory system which is consisting of the arteries and the veins, and it is often expanded into an extensive hemocoel. So hemocoel is a cavity which is present in place of coelom, and all these ventral and the arteries and the veins are being suspended there, or are being carrying the blood and depositing the blood into that hemocoel. Respiration is by gills or by the pulmonary sacs. Pulmonary sacs are organisms that can be seen in the lowermost part. Here the pulmonary sacs are present. The nervous system consists of circumesophageal ring and with cerebral and pleural ganglia. They have pleural cords and visceral loops. So these are some cords and loops present in the anterior portion, and these are constituting the cephalization or the head portion of the mollusca. Sense organs, they include eyes and receptors for touch, smell and taste. Now they have almost all the receptors in them. The sexes are usually separate, and mostly they are oviparous. Oviparous means they lay eggs. Fertilization is external and development is direct. So the development is directly from the, there are very few larval stages if present, and mostly they are absent, and development directly occurs from the parent to a new individual, and the fertilization is external. So this is the outermost covering, which is the dorsal part, and this is, you can see if we turn over this, this is the segmentation. You can see the foot, mantle and the mouth, and these are the gills. Gills are for the organs of respiration. The echinodermata we will do in the next class.